We are at the Biodiversity Park, Gurgaon, and my guest today is this amazing woman, Latika Thukral, founder of Iamgurgaon, which is the organization which has created and maintaining this beautiful park of native species and creating a forest out here. So Latika, welcome to our interview series. Could you share a little bit about yourself to start with?
Okay. So how
did this all start?
We've been living in Gurgaon forever now. It's nearly 20 years. And 7 years back when we started Iamgurgaon, we felt there was a need to do something to Gurgaon because having moved in from Delhi, this place was growing in a very haphazard manner. And we were aware of this piece of land, like all other forest land. We suggested to the commissioner that time, Mr. Khulla.
This was in 2007?
This is in 2009 and 10. Yeah. And he got very excited, though he didn't know the status of this land, but he really got excited and he said, let's do it. And that's how this whole thing started. We started to get the boundary wall, the walking path, cycling path. This forest making has not even closed for a single day. So what you see or what everybody sees, it's a forest in making. And when we and it started with just 5,000 saplings, which was planted by Forest Department. All of a sudden, we came with this idea of planting million trees in Gurgaon. And then after Mr. Khulla moved away, Mr. Sudhir Rajpal was the commissioner, and he said, if you want to plant million trees, why not at the Biodiversity Park? This whole thing fell in our lap. We didn't know how to do it. None of us had the, we were not from the background of plantation or all of us are corporate people. We said, what do we do? So we started to figure out, we started to reaching out to people who are experts in this field. And this is how we reached Pradeep Kishan. And because we had heard about him and he's one of the experts on Aravalli species,
so,
and has written a book,
this book on Trees of Delhi. One of the most iconic books if
absolutely.
You want to read about
absolutely.
Trees of
so
Delhi.
Having said that, we said we want to do the right way.
Yeah.
We reached out to him and he referred us to Vijit Hashmana, who came on board as a consultant
project.
To us and a project leader. And it's easy to say that let's make a forest or we can plant. But where do you get those native species? Nobody in the country was really growing these species. I mean, the best we could get was about 30 species in Jodhpur and Udaipur forest nursery, and that's it. And we started with this whole thing about creating a list. And this list was created by looking at the gazetteers and all from British time, that what were the species available. What do we call Aravalli species? So we got through this list and realized that there were some of 250 species, which includes of course shrubs and.
So what was this land when you first started in 2019?
Okay, this had become a mining site. We had and encroached and dumped and all, and there was nothing. You know, if you look at before and after photographs now, it had totally become a denuded site. So, you know, you really needed to revive it. You
and
needed
I'm guessing
to
full of vilayati kikar that time?
It was full of vilayati kikar.
Yeah, just like all the other places.
Yes, absolutely. It was only full of vilayati kikar. So our first step was to remove vilayati kikar, and large part of that, some part of the vilayati kikar was removed by the Forest Department, the Haryana Forest
Development. So the Forest Development now?
No, Haryana Forest Development.
Haryana. Oh, Haryana Forest?
HFDC, not okay, Forest right. Department. So MCG had given them to plant some 5,000 saplings, and they were not native. So they did not plant native species. They did a mix of all, and but they did
probably
remove
roadside trees.
Yeah, absolutely. So you also have a pilkhunt, and you also have all kinds of.
Sure, that happens with all horticulture departments.
Yeah. And if today you ask me, I understand word native, but when we started, for us, native was a neem also, and a bargad also, and gulmohar, right? Everything was native. But today our definition of native has changed. And native to a particular place, which does not need so much of looking after. It grows on its own. It gets the The whole ecology changes when you plant native species, and that's what one is realizing, because the bird population has increased, the butterflies, the insects, and everything has started.
Tell us how do native trees enhance the flora?
So I'll go back to it, that how did we then decided to get native saplings? So when we started, the issue was where to get those saplings. Mm-hmm. And at that stage, the first reach was this Udaipur Jodhpur, when we got 30 species, and that also were not enough. So we started to decided to set up a nursery. Okay. And today, I think the nursery is the backbone of biodiversity. And we have about 180 odd species
which are growing here.
Yes.
And two nurseries?
We have two nurseries now. Grown, we started with
we'll
one.
Probably just go around
absolutely,
to them, right?
Absolutely. And also, we are very, very fortunate. This all would have not been possible without the help of course, MCG is the owner of this land, but besides them, the corporates of Gurgaon.
Okay.
This whole project is funded by corporates.
How many of them?
Over 45.
Wow.
Yeah.
And
so,
how much? If you don't mind sharing.
So each year we try to plant about 15 to 16,000 saplings. We charge now 650 rupees per sapling, and we maintain it for 3 years. So you and over the years, our success rate is also 90%.
90%? I thought it was 40% when I last read an article. That must be an old article, of course.
Well, the first year.
Oh, first year.
First year.
Went up from 10% with the Haryana government or Haryana HFDC, probably 240%.
And the first year, we did struggle because we had not planted native species. I mean, and there were a lot of.
So native species are hardier, is it?
They are hardier. You don't require so much of water. We don't need to water every day, and they kind of learn to survive on their own. So we don't water every day. We today have over 80,000 saplings in the park, and I mean I don't like to say it park. It's a forest in making.
Yeah.
But yes, it's called Aravalli Biodiversity Park. So we are trying to, what we're trying to now do is maintain it for 3 years. And afterwards, we kind of realize that they survive on their own. And with our 90% survival rate, the replantation, which takes place in monsoon, is restricted to just 10% of the old stock.
How many? Trees are there right now.
It's over 80,000.
Over 80,000 at this point in time.
Also, what happens is when you protect an area, a lot of ingrowth which comes up. So, you know, the grazing has stopped over the years, and that has also led to
probably seeds come out and they start spreading.
Absolutely.
So there is, you know, automatic regeneration.
Absolutely. And also, what we have tried to do.
So, what is this?
This is called Goya Care.
Okay,
it's
also
a shrub.
Native.
It's also native, of course. Everything is native.
Native,
and
yeah.
What you can also see is that this must be unique in a forest that we have drip irrigation.
Oh, okay.
And again, fortunate enough that there is a corporate who funded us and we could do it. It wasn't easy to do this drip irrigation, but today, and it really helps. It helps in many ways. One is that the growth is better because the water comes in at a slow speed. And secondly, it is reducing the cost of
water
and labor.
And what sort of water is this? Fresh water that comes here? Do you have a bore well?
Okay,
I
so we do
that
it both ways.
There is a
so we
treated
do it,
water.
Yeah, so we do it both ways. We are not able to get everything from outside.
Mm-hmm.
We do use 50% water from the bore well, but we also are making an effort. I mean, we get water from sewage treatment plant, which is the STP of DLF, and they've been kind enough to give us free water.
Okay.
We send our tankers to get it. So that's an expense which we have to take every day. But it's still worth it, because when you're doing the right thing, we feel that you should try and use sewage treated water. If we can get more, we would
there
be
very
happy.
There is no way to pipe it here.
There isn't a way. I mean, I think they're thinking of finding out. But as this park is maturing, we might even not need water in years to come, because it should grow on its own. You don't need to water after, 3 years. And besides, in a place like this, it's just not about maintenance. There is hell of a lot of work which comes up with it, which is which is, you know, I mean, we've put in a lot of effort in taking out Vilaiti Kikar Prosopis Juli Flora. There is, in last 6 years, I think we have taken out close to 90%, if not more.
Yes, it's pretty much.
It's pretty much not there. There are just one.
You see one or two of those big large ones. Right at the top somewhere.
Yeah, slowly. And we've been also using the Vilaiti Kikar to make the. If you can see this,
this is to protect our saplings from Nilgai.
So now they've grown, so it's not a worry. So these Vilaiti Kikar, Vilaiti Kikar is, it's like your tree guard.
Yeah.
So if you go at the back, so every sapling is kind of.
Thoda hamare listeners ke liye, audience ke liye bataye ki, tell us about Vilaiti Kikar. Iski kya khamiya hai aur.
Okay. So Vilaiti Kikar, which is also called Prosopis Juli Flora, it's a pest. It is not. It doesn't belong to India. It came in with Britishers. And
isse hota 1908, I believe. I read in Pradeep's book.
Yeah, 1908, and Britishers had spread the seeds. And this was, I mean, if you look at from their point of view, this was to earmark the forest land.
Yeah, they wanted to make the president's house, the president look over a green forest instead of a brown forest.
Absolutely, and that was an easy way to say that, okay, we have protected our land. But what it's done is it's spread like a wildfire, and now people feel very excited. People feel very excited about this. It looks green, but it doesn't allow other species to grow, and it has dual roots. So it takes a lot
which means double roots, which takes a lot of
water out of the ground.
Okay.
So, and also doesn't allow anything else to grow.
I've heard its roots are also. Has a acidic sort of nature or something.
I don't know. I mean, I'm not so sure about it. But what I understand is that as you keep removing them and replant with the native species, the whole ecology of this place has changed. And it is what we hear from birders. Again, I'm not a birder and I'm not an expert. They say that it has become one of the most important birding sites in NCR. So this is just in 5-6 years. So it feels good because we see a lot of birders coming here, and some of the rare species are also seen.
Wonderful.
Yeah. So
there are 250 species of birds.
I think it's about 180, which you have seen here over the.
We should do an interview with the birder here next time and then find out.
Absolutely. And in fact, we in next 2 months we will have a booklet out. On common bird scene in this place.
Wonderful.
So that's also ready to be recently
on one of the Facebook posts saw the a jackal catching a hare.
Right. It was here only.
Here only.
Yes,
okay.
Absolutely.
So there are now jackals in this place.
It is there. Jackal, civet cat. We have monitor lizard.
Wow.
And you see a lot of insects and reptiles. So snakes during monsoons.
Yes,
you will
even
see
I've seen a snake sitting on one of the trees during the monsoons.
You see a lot of snakes during monsoon time. So I think, and also what we have tried to do is that just not plant trees. So we've also added a lot of shrubs because the trees are going to take its own time to grow. They have their own time by which they will really take growth. So in meanwhile, we have got undergrowth story.
Yeah.
So if you see, all these are shrubs. And once the trees come in, there will be a survival of the fittest, and they'll figure out
which one will take.
Yeah.
Yeah, it looks beautiful. There's lots of grass. I remember coming here many years ago, 5-6 years, I guess. It used to be barren, completely, yes.
And also I think what we have tried to do is to not cut anything. The only thing we cut from here is Congress grass.
Yeah.
And if Lantana comes up at times, and that's it. Nothing else.
So Lantana, Congress grass,
and if there are these Prosopis Juli Flora, which is a
tree.
And it keeps coming. Prosopis Juli Flora also, if you don't take out from the root, it keeps coming.
Very
up. So you have to keep that as a maintenance.
So just a deviation, what is this?
It's an amphitheater. This amphitheater was made while we started this project, and it can take about 700 people.
Wow.
I'm sorry, there you can see these fencing all over.
This wasn't there earlier.
No, it has been done because people jump in there and they break, there are seating out there, yes. And they kind of break it. So, I mean, we have a lot of vandalism issues out here. Yeah. I mean, if the bin's lying around, they will break it. So, don't know what to do. Yeah. We have to live with it.
Sad reality.
That's sad reality.
Of the country or our country in general sometimes.
And we have also grown 40 species of grasses.
Okay. So, then there are trees.
There are shrubs, climbers.
200.
We have a list of 250,
which includes
trees and shrubs
and grasses.
And grasses, okay.
And so, how many grasses? What's the
about 40 species we have added into the park?
And what are grasses? If you could show us something.
So this is a grass. Those are grasses. Some of them would have been growing on their own. In fact, I'll take you to, there is an area which is full of sacrum grass, mm-hmm. and where you will find beaver birds. So, you know, you kind of not touching anything here unless required. You're leaving areas the way they are. We are only doing intervention by planting.
There is something somewhere around, there is something for water conservation also. Is that over there?
No, it's here. If you go that side.
So we'll just go
there.
There
is a pond. We have created a pond. Also, because it used to be a mining site, so water does collect during monsoon season. I have experimented with two ponds. Mm-hmm. One has done well, the second one didn't do. But the other places also, some of the other areas, the water stays for a couple of months in monsoon time, when it collects in monsoon time, but then it dries off, it evaporates.
So what is this there? Using cans and pipes?
Again, we have made our life a little difficult. We try to water through cans. The reason for that is we don't want any water to be wasted.
Okay.
With the pipe, the water will get wasted because they are spread all over.
And unfortunately, this reminds me, whenever I go to the Lutyens, Delhi,
there are these
black pipes to water little tracts of
water
some
being
bushes.
Wasted. Yes, my absolutely.
God, burns my heart.
Absolutely. So one of the reasons, we don't want any water to be wasted. Secondly, we also want to measure how much water we give.
Mm-hmm.
So they know that if it is a shrub, we need to give 5 liters. If it's a tree,
so like this one,
a small shrub.
This is
a tree, so they would be given more. But like a small shrub, we will give 5 liters, and that's good enough.
For how long?
Every time we tell them to do it, this because it doesn't need that kind
but
of.
But how long? How? When will this tree get
so we,
water
we
next time?
So we just keep this as is for 3 years. We will water every sapling for 3 years.
How and frequently?
In summer months, it's about a week, once a week. And there can be 4 times also if it's really, really hot. But once in 4 days. But generally once a week. And in winter, we go up to 10 to 12 days also. And if it rains, of course, then. So you're trying to do everything for them.
This also
then we will stop watering. So now we know that the trees don't need watering because these must be the new ones we are adding shrubs. So this is a continuous process, you keep adding.
So some trees have grown. Was this planted by you?
Actually, this wasn't planted.
It was already there. There are some bigger trees here.
This is sesham and all these have been planted before. And again, sesham is not really native to...
Oh, is it? It's all over Haryana.
Yeah. Also, what happens with this, with sesham is, one, it spreads very fast. I mean, the seedlings spread. And secondly, people will come and cut them. So, we have to be careful that you don't overdo on sesham. Which people don't realize, and also we are trying not to do monoculture.
It's a mix of it,
and each area has different kind of plantation.
Take us through some of this.
I think care. And we'll go up.
Okay.
There is, the one now which is there is a hill which is full of
cow. Again is a very. Dhau or
dhok, which is the mangar bunny special. Like this is the dhok. This is a small sapling.
Dhok has this thing about if Vijay was telling me if it, you know, a cow or something eats, it will spread like a carpet.
Yes. So if it doesn't allow you to grow, it just spreads. And it is supposed to be the strongest wood in India.
Oh
yeah.
very hardy, because it grows next to rocks. And on
very, very hardy.
On slopes of hills.
Absolutely.
So this is also one of our oldest plantation. This would be about 4 years old. This area is about 4 years
old. Look beautiful.
So every area has at a different time of plantation, and some are 1 year old, some are 5 years old, and this is about 4 years old.
I mean, you know, I don't remember when I've become a little irregular here, but earlier you could see a lot of
surface. Till there. And you could see the surface as well as you can't see.
It's just covered with grasses and
you can see trees. The dots, whether the trees are taking longer to come up or they will take their own time
you
to
could see dots.
Height.
Exactly.
But they are
now
there.
Now it's true forest. I guess in monsoons it will all
look
be
different.
Lush green.
Yeah.
We'll come back and shoot this in monsoons.
This looks absolutely different.
Beautiful.
It just looks different.
So those are the water tankers, is it? That,
So we have a full, factory out here. We have our own two tractors, four tankers, water
all
tankers.
Funded by the
corporates in Gurgaon. So this whole, and our own trolley, everything. Everything is thanks to
corporates
who felt that this is a project.
Which you and your team have gone and raised.
You know, actually, first 2 years, we really had to, first year friends and relatives, and mainly friends and relatives who came and helped, and our spouses, their companies and all that, they came and helped. But now word of mouth is spreading. And
wonderful.
Last 2-3 years, we don't really need to go and look for funds. They come.
It just comes.
They come.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
So you were a banker,
right?
Before this,
yes.
And you quit to do this, or did you quit? How did it?
Well,
how did that happen?
I quit because I wanted. I had spent 18 years with Citibank, and I quit to spend more time with my boys, who were 10 and 12 at that time. And in the process wanted to do something. Hmm. Didn't know, and I wanted to do something to save Gurgaon. This much I knew, but didn't know how it will happen. What will I do? And I think in a year's time after I quit, three of us started Iamgurgaon, which is Swanzil Kapoor, Ambika Agarwal, and I. We set up Iamgurgaon, and again.
Now it's a bigger team?
It's a much bigger team, yeah. And we were about 8-10 of us who kind of, we three founded it, and then there's a team which came together. But now we have dedicated people who are all volunteers. So all of us are volunteers. This is again an NGO where each one of us is giving time without monetary benefit. And we have a few people, a couple of people who are hired. All staff at the Biodiversity Park is of course paid.
Of course, I mean, I guess project directors, people who work, who do the digging, they all have to be paid.
Absolutely.
This is part of their job. So
yes, absolutely.
So, how big is the area?
It's about 350 acres.
Oh, yeah, okay. And I've even read somehow that, you know, there is this, I've actually heard Vijay saying that his dream is that somewhere between Sariska and Delhi, it's a continuity of the ridge.
Absolutely.
Can you share what that
you know,
is
I mean,
about?
Even forget about that. Gurgaon has so much of area like this. I wish we can spread a similar experiment.
All around.
It's
all
there another,
Thankfully,
1,000 acre which we can change it into a place like this. Yes, absolutely.
But of course, there are roads cutting all of that.
And at different status. Some belong to forest, some belong to MCG. And it's also an intent of the government what they want to do.
So is this a forest?
This is a Gair Mumkin Pahar, which is this land belongs to Municipal Corporation of Gurgaon, and they agreed to experiment on this, and I think we are just fortunate that a place like this has come up in Gurgaon.
So is this, you know, it's very difficult to change the label of a forest land and make it, you know, change it to a non-forest land now in India with the tough environment rules. So is this declared a forest or no, or is it likely to be?
This is called the Biodiversity Park. It is called and it's a forest in making, but I personally feel that the government also has an attachment now to it, and they won't play around with a place like this. But no, it doesn't have a forest status in that sense for
now. Would you like that to happen?
Of course. We want this place to be protected totally. And what we want is, we have, Iamgurgaon is going to be taking care of this place for next 2 or 3 years more, you know, because the plantation will be over.
Why? And what after that?
So we have a contract with municipal government for 8 years,
starting
of which 2012, and of which 4 or 5 years are over. So 2 to 3 years more. I feel that we need to institutionalize this place now. It cannot be left for MCG to decide, or an officer in MCG to decide what should be done at this place.
Sure.
Because I don't think people really are understanding what is happening. This is in true sense a forest in making, and it cannot be treated like a park.
Yeah.
It cannot have saying that a place like this has come, we must monetize it, or we must have a cafe, or we must have a night safari or whatever. It isn't. It is unique. It's a city forest, and it needs that kind of treatment, where we need to be sensitive to the fact that today there are birds who have made this their
180
home.
Species.
And birds have made their home, and will they be affected if we do more construction, or if we make a cafe, or we do something like this? So it's something I think environmentalists can suggest to the government or people that what should be done. You know, it should not be I feel it should be institutionalized.
There are tracks here, there are cycling tracks, walking tracks along with the forest, just that, and maybe just
leave it
at that,
and allow it to evolve and become whatever it is.
So after these 2 years, you'll stop planting anymore?
So we will stop. I don't think we will need to plant after 2 to 3 years. We only now do replacement. At this stage, we are only working on replacement. So, and this year we will have a space for another 5,000-6,000. By and large, we would have planted all across the park.
Okay, and so then it's what you're trying to. What you're also saying then is that it's probably become a self-regenerating.
Absolutely,
sort of,
as well as we will. You're finding new species. So you're growing new species every year. Like this year, we have added 3-4 more species in our nurseries. Which hadn't been. So they will come into this place. So
that part is still.
Actually, this is the place where it got fire. Few days back.
Oh, right. That's why it's all burnt.
Yeah. So this place caught fire a while back. Luckily, the damage has not been that much. In fact, what is interesting is that Dhau species, Dhau saplings, which had gone totally burnt out, are sprouting.
Oh my. So how big is this area now?
This is about 350 acres. It touches the Delhi. There is a forest land that side also, so it touches that forest.
Yeah, I see all Vilayati Kikar suddenly.
Yeah,
that's
absolutely.
Probably the boundary.
Boundary wall of, and you can see that wall.
Yes.
As well, you can see that mandir.
Yeah.
That's
the first one. Second,
the first one. The first one. And that is. Till that point is our this part of biodiversity park, and you can see those green tanks.
Yeah,
that's where we store water.
And here there are the buildings, the DLF buildings,
phase 3. Then you see the metro.
And, so that's
again the Delhi Kitorni, and
never have a sense otherwise of how big 350 acres.
And you can see, like you said, that you can see the green. So that's all Vilayati Kikar.
And people, from the metro, they get to see the Vilayati Kikar,
and they get very excited. What a green place.
Yeah.
And one should see land under the Vilayati Kikar. It's actually barren.
Yes. In fact, in a large part of the Buddha Jayanti Park, and even the Sanjay Van,
which has
all Vilayati Kikar, only inside parts where there has been protection and all, there are different species. But it's all Vilayati Kikar, and hardly anything grows.
That's true.
Pradeep told us that there was a grass, this heath. This is the only hardy
which stays
grass,
in,
which sort of stays, but otherwise everything dies.
Yeah. And Karonda and all the most other. They also, I think, kind of. I have seen a lot of Karonda near Vilayati Kikar. So
what
you
is
can
the
see
status
these,
of?
You can see all these keep coming on their own and on. We will not cut anything.
Yeah.
So they will come on their own.
It's all
they will
wild
go on
grasses,
their own,
wild flowers.
And
So what is the status now of vilayati kikar? Is it now recognized by the government as an invasive species? Can we
they understand. So I think what I believe is that there is a high court order which says, which was I think permission from which was one CR Babu, filed that case, where they are saying that you could, if you take out vilayati kikar, you have to replace it
with something. But you're legally allowed now to take it out.
Yes, I think so.
Oh, we should get access to that.
Yes, that's what I have seen, because we have taken out everything, and Forest HFDC had done it. And I think Forest Department also is now trying to work on taking out vilayati kikar to replace it with native species.
I remember once, several years ago, I'm talking about 2007-8 sometime, talking to Sunita Narayan at Center for Science and Environment. And I had just gotten to know about vilayati kikar that time. I spoke to her that it is a devastating tree. Sunita had said it is, but you know what it has also done is solved India's fuel wood crisis.
That's true.
All over India, it grows so fast.
Also, it is useful to have it where you want to hold
the water together.
I mean, it has its own advantages.
Yeah, I guess to hydrogenate the soil at least to where it is already devastated like it was here. Then you start taking it out.
Absolutely. And you're replacing it, and you are treating it differently. Otherwise, but I wish we can, you know, do a similar thing in other areas in Gurgaon.
So that's where I was going to next. So what is the potential of now taking this? After 2 years, this is done and settled.
I don't think it'll be done in 2 years. It needs another 5 to 7 years. And also a place like this, like if you go to a Madhav National Park or any of the national park, and it will reach to that status in that sense. It needs intervention. Needs care. It needs a lot of during monsoon, we'll realize that a lot of congress grass and others will come in with pests and all, which have to be taken out. So there's a continuous work which needs
course.
To be
done. I mean, Jim Corbett, half the job of the Forest Department.
What
I don't know. Maybe I'm exaggerating, but is to take out lantana.
Absolutely. So you know, we did a war footing lantana at 1 year. This is 2 years back or three? 2 years back. Lantana was spreading at really like in a crazy way. So we on war footing removed lantana. And today if we see one lantana, you know, shrub, we kind of don't let it be.
Fantastic.
So you can, you know, you're spending a lot of everybody says that you have 650 rupees per sapling. It's just not about watering. It's just not about maintaining. It is more than that. It is a hell of a lot of work besides that. Plus, it has fencing around it. In last 5 years, we have evolved a lot. But in initial years, we have some bit of relief in last 2 years. But till we still have fence being cut on a daily basis.
Oh, by the
villagers or people around the cattle grazing. They will put their goats in. So we have two people whose job is only to look at repairing fencing on a daily basis. Every day there is a new place from where the animals have been.
So that land beyond the temple also is free, and probably
it belongs to Delhi government. It's a forest land. It has a forest status.
So there is a potential of extending this into Delhi.
Absolutely.
And so,
I mean, you can see that wall. Now that wall has come to break between Delhi
forest land and now
this
forest.
So
what can be done over there?
You can extend this and it can become
how?
By planting similar species.
No, I know, but how do you approach the Delhi government? Is there?
So we have tried doing it, and I think this government under AAP has also, but it doesn't work unless somebody really, really wants to do it. You know, we've just been lucky. I think there was some God intervention that Gurgaon has got a place like this. Yeah, and we were fortunate to be able to work on this and get funding from corporates. It's not easy for government to do this. It's just not easy for them to do it.
And so, Mangar, just a few days back by the Haryana government, the new Khattar government, has been declared a no construction zone. That's been a blessing. About 550-600 acres.
Absolutely.
And about double that periphery area
has been.
So that's not too far from here, and no. There is probably continuity of forest land from here until there.
Absolutely.
You think we can actually give continuity from here rather than the road?
I wish.
It's just not difficult to do it. So you have to put more pressure on the Haryana government to actually allocate it to Iamgurgaon.
It doesn't matter who they allocate to. It could be forest doing it. Today, there is an experiment which has worked. So it can be replicated. We would be very happy to take on more. More than anything else, we've kind of now, in last 5 years, understood how it is to be done. We will make less mistakes. We have gone through our own share of mistakes also. So we will do it a better job. And we have all... now infrastructure in place to be able to do it. We had to set this up. Yeah. If we get
so it's probably time to now start pressurizing both the Delhi and Haryana.
I think they are also wanting to do it. Yeah. Forest department is looking to take up more areas and plant. And what is nice is that they are talking to you. So yeah, they're not thinking to. They are not treating you like an outsider. Oh, you guys don't know it. We are collaborating. We are talking about it. We have all the time. And the forest department, at least at this point in time, we have a good officer, conservator forest, is Mr. Haryana. Sinha. And he's a good officer who is very proactive, who is interacting with you, who's happy to, like last time he had a meeting, he had got all his range officers to come and look at our nursery.
Oh, wow.
And we are not talking to each other, where do you get your seeds and where can we get seeds and, you know, things like that, which is very, very nice. And I think that's the only way it can function, because we have the passion and they have the areas, and we can together make this a reality. But it's not easy. It's a very, very, very tough job. There are people who did not believe in the project like this. They couldn't understand what we were trying to do. Initially, everybody used to stop us and ask us, why are you not planting neem and bargat and jamun ka and aam ka ped, and you literally had to go through the same story again, what we're trying to do. And initially, as we also did not have saplings, I mean, in the sense that big saplings, they were small, they were growing in the nursery. Today, we are in a different state, our saplings are bigger, we have lots of species, so and it's visible. So people do understand, people come in on a daily basis, understand what has got done in the place, in a place like this. So. But initially, as we were questioned a lot. Had newspaper articles every now and then trying to rubbish us, happens now also, so it's okay. In the sense that now, because it's become what it has become, everybody wants to take control and make it into something else. But we have to keep a vision. So like, personally, if you ask me, I think we should have a vision. We have a vision for Biodiversity Park. That vision needs to be it's documented with the MCG. It needs to be institutionalized. So you institutionalize, you say, hey, listen, next 10 years we're going to be looking at it as a forest, and we will only do what is good for the place. So that's a tough one. It's not easy for anybody to.
Sure, sir. Tell me, help me with this. What does really institutionalized mean? So you're now out, it is 2-3 years later.
Whether we are there or not, we are just an executing body. We are not owners of this place.
What does institutionalized mean? Which means that you protect the fences.
What I mean to see about institutionalized is to set up a body, which is, you give it a status, which could be a heritage site, it could be a conservation.
Or convert it to a forest land.
Or a forest conservation site, whatever you want to do it, and have people... In the team means you form a committee which has experts from the government, from civil society, from environmentalists, so that there is a proper plan for something like, place like
so
this.
So continuity, because, if nothing else, at least maintenance, the fencing, uprooting of
all Lantana. That will happen, but like if a MCG commissioner, each MCG commissioner, the biggest challenge what you have in the government is that every officer who comes in has a plan in mind.
Okay.
And each officer wants to do different from what other has done.
Okay.
The one officer will want to do is a night safari. The other guy will want to make it into a scorpio park, or they want to get alligators out. So we've heard all kinds of things which can be done. Or we want to make it into a park, or we want to make it into an Ayurvedic center, or we will put camps out here. No, it isn't. It's a forest in making. It's a city forest. Leave it for your children. Yeah. They would have never known that there is something called native species. Yeah. Today, we are getting schools to come in and participate in this whole plantation. We get them to learn about the species which are planted here. We get corporates to come and plant. So there is a huge amount of interaction of civil society in this place. And our next generation will know what it means.
They will see
to
a true forest.
They will see a new forest. They will know
one day that in 10 years these will be.
Yeah, absolutely. And they will know. I mean, for they will know what is a native. What is a native forest mean? It is not trees which are plant coming from outside. You know, I mean, generally, if you know, everybody is growing ornamental trees. Whole of Gurgaon is growing ornamental trees. So I think it's something for the next generation.
So we are here at your one of the two nurseries. So let's go in and talk us through what is growing. They look like
big saplings now. Yeah, now they are about 2 to 3 years old, and today we have an opportunity to plant bigger saplings, which we didn't have in the first 2-3 years. And obviously, when the saplings are bigger, they kind of survive better. So what you see is, what we do is that we'll go to the other nursery. In that nursery, we put seeds, and from there the saplings come out, and then they are moved from smaller bags to bigger bags to bigger bags into bigger bags. So this is
huge.
Yeah,
never seen saplings this big.
No, you would have seen, but they would cost
a lot. I mean, not saplings, but I mean even.
Yeah. So you
like
keep moving them. Yeah, you keep moving them.
So
from,
you actually take them out of the smaller bags, put
and
them
then
in a bigger,
bigger bag. Yeah, sure. That's how the movement
takes
place.
Because normally, otherwise, the roots are like all congested.
Not going to, yes. So now we are ready to plant them. This is karonda.
What all is here? This is karonda.
That is harshingar.
Harshingar. Ah, yeah. Beautiful smelling flowers.
Yes.
This also is native, thou. Is it? Thou. I thought it was ornamental once again.
That's thou. And last one year, we've been very, very lucky with thou. Thou doesn't, they say that the conversion rate or whatever, the survival rate of seeds to sapling is about 10%.
Very low.
Very, very low. Yeah. But we've done well. We've taken it up to 30-40%. We've done something right.
Excellent.
And which we know what we've done right, and these are now growing. We would have in Biodiversity Park at least 7,000
thou.
Feel very, very excited about it. It's alive.
Almost blue. Like for the Aravalli Rocky terrain.
It's very special.
It's almost like this top of the, like conserve the tiger and everything gets conserved.
It's probably on absolutely. So, this is Bistendu.
Bistendu.
Yeah. And what we also try to do is
that palash, dhak?
That's dhak, right. Yeah. That's dhak. And you know what, if you see, we have trees growing between the nursery. So at any point in time, we move out of this nursery, you will have a jungle out here also. So we'll leave behind.
So this will not be barren land.
It won't be barren land. It will have trees around. So
is that the Delhi border?
Yeah, why do you ask? Because there is all
Vilayati Kikar.
Yeah, that's Delhi border, and it's actually India-Pakistan divide. but we do need a little protection at this time because Delhi border is not fully secured. So there's a huge amount of grazing which takes place.
So tell me, how has this area, or is this forest, affected or helped build communities? Has there been some, how are the villagers reacting?
Okay.
Is it good, bad for them?
No, it's very interesting because when we started working on this project and we started planting, I still remember it was about 45 degrees and I was in the middle of somewhere here, which is about a kilometer inside, and I was walking and there was some planting happening and I was standing there, And one of the villagers walked up to me, ki yahan kya ho raha hai? So I said, hum paudhe kar rahe. And next I knew that this guy had gone to his village, which is close by, and got us chaat. And he says, madam, aap itni garmi mein kaam kar rahe hain, so, you know, and that was the starting of getting to know villagers around.
You know, so that reminds me of a very interesting story. Sorry to interrupt you. The waterman, Rajinder Singh.
Yes, yes.
He was with an organization, I think, whether it was Tarun Bharat Sangh or before that some organization, maybe it just joined Tarun Bharat Sangh. And I remember reading that he was digging and somebody came up to him and said, he was digging or doing something. What was the story? Yeah, he actually had gone to the villagers to do some good for them, and you know, he was on this mission to do some good things for the village. And then an old man came and told him that tum mara bhala karna chahte ho na, kal subah 5 baje phavda leke yahan par pahunch jana kisi jagah. And that's what Rajinder Singh did. And you know, he said that basically hamare ko pani conserve karna hai, water conserve karna.
Absolutely.
And that changed everything.
Absolutely.
For he's now
absolutely
one
called the waterman. Absolutely.
Sorry to interrupt you.
No,
please
no,
proceed
no, absolutely.
With your story.
So what, and that was the starting of trying to get to know people who you would not meet otherwise in your Indian, now that we have all
in
city
urban life.
Yeah. And today, I think the people from villages whose land we are sitting on, they and us interact. We get invited by them for their children's weddings.
Yeah,
or, so it's very nice because they will, if you're passing by, you will always, we will greet each other. And I think it would have not been possible.
So it's both sides. It's
both
at
sides.
The same time cutting the fences, sending goats in and cattle in, and
yeah,
also the other side,
yeah, absolutely,
people who revere and
absolutely
love
and
the
they
forest.
Come here. I mean, they come here for walks in the morning.
Yeah. I just saw while coming
yeah,
in
yeah,
two guys doing kushti.
Yes, and they're using this place as much as we are, and we are, and they kind of feel happy about what has happened to this area. But I feel that I think it's been one of the villagers were telling me, that because of Biodiversity Park, people from 4 villages which is next to Biodiversity Park have met.
Oh.
And he says this used to happen with our grandparents. Now that we have all spread out, we were never ever meeting. But it's because of Biodiversity Park.
Because they're coming for walks and
yes,
morning.
From Chakrapur, Nathupur, Ayanagar, all of them come here for a walk.
Wonderful.
And they all together, I think, do Bhandara each year. So I think it's exciting. It's exciting to know that we have connected people,
so
and we have got connected to them.
Social fabric getting connected around a forest also.
Absolutely, absolutely. And we are as much benefiting out of it. They are including us in their lives, which we would have never got an opportunity. So I do end up going for a lot of marriages,
weddings,
and I do go. This is that famous kullu, which is called Ghost Tree.
Ghost Tree, kullu,
yeah.
Excellent. You know, there's this very interesting story. Vijay had taken us for a walk to Mangar, and while coming back from, you know, the other side of Mangar, visited somebody's house over there. I was driving, Vijay was sitting next to me, and he suddenly says, stop the car, ruko. And I said, what happened, you know? So he showed us a tree, then he said, walked up to the hill. So it was about 50 meters away or something, you know. And he calls up Pradeep Krishan and tells him, I have a gift for you. So it seems it was a big kullu tree. And
there aren't many here.
According to him, it was the only surviving kullu tree that they had seen in the Delhi NCR region.
Wow. So out here we have planted maybe over 200-300 trees.
Wonderful. Very difficult to grow. I remember I was experimenting with seeds and seed balls.
And it was not easy.
None of them grew. Vijay was furious at me for trying to seed them.
And it's very beautiful.
Beautiful tree. So we are inside this greenhouse.
Yeah.
So tell us more, please.
So these are our beds where we will we sow seeds, and once these saplings start coming out, we take them out.
So like all these are coming, saplings
yes,
from seeds.
These are all coming.
Alag alag hai kya?
No, these are the same. This is a bigger one. Okay. It's growing. And once they come out, we will move them into small bags. And like you see there, so they have been taken out and put it in those bags.
Okay. And so while taking them out, they don't get spoiled?
No, there is a technique to it, of course. There is a technique to it, which of course Malis know now. And we will take them out, put them into those small bags.
Yeah.
Small bags and you know when we plant, you can see out here they or the names are there, the dates are mentioned. So we kind of monitor how many days it has taken for it to sprout.
Oh, okay.
So all that is tracked. So all the names have been
put. Beautiful, and this keeps changing. So once
obviously,
some
yeah,
sapling,
yeah,
then another
depending on the season and all. So now they move to the bigger. They are
so taken out, put in these plastic bags, then taken
then,
out.
Then they are kept in for a few months, and then when we realize they're becoming bigger, then they move to the bigger
bags. Yeah. Bigger bags.
So I can take you to the other nursery. So we have just about 2 acres of area.
2 acres dedicated
yeah,
to the nursery. Brilliant. So how does it? How is it feeling? I was in Almora 2 years ago in a beautiful bio resort there called Sona Pani, and
yeah.
I remember speaking to Ashish, I think, and he had an opportunity there to, the village panchayat was saying that about 50 acres of land, and he'd called an Australian company to do some digging. So the digging for trees is very fast
yes.
with that machine or whatever.
Yes, absolutely.
It is. So they were coming to Almora for a demonstration, and the village panchayat, you know, had allocated that 50 acres of land because he's built a trust with them and all of that. And he was telling me that, Rahul, mera na, I feel that mera ye wala jeevan tript ho gaya. Matlab, meri sari teerth yatra sab ho gayi. So, I mean, just connecting that.
I think all of us at Iamgurgaon feel that we have done something for Gurgaon. And once you come here, and you can see the smile on my face, I just feel so excited because we are really leaving behind a legacy. And for our next generation. So it's something which has happened because everybody believed in it. I mean, everybody means it started with the government, the administration helping us out, and people of Gurgaon. This wouldn't have been possible if it wasn't their support and funding and of course, there is a huge amount of passion gone into it, and we all have.
And you've involved the community, like you were saying, villagers from around. I know I've been part of the school's plantation.
Yes, absolutely. And
well, so.
And all the Malis are living in the next. So we have about 65 Malis.
Oh, wow,
they
wonderful.
All come from the next village.
Villages.
Yes.
So it's a source of employment also. Are these
absolutely.
Permanent people, like full-time?
Full-time. We have about 60 odd Malis
right.
and 4 supervisors. So they are full-time and been with us. Some of them have been with us forever. I mean, we started 5 years ago since then. So there is about 20-30% have been with us since then.
So here also, within the nursery, there
yes,
are
there are
trees, there is barkat here. There is,
so all... our whole intent
is origin, is it? No. No,
I don't know. Ye kaun sa ped hai? Ye wala?
Same name. Origin hai. Arjun.
Arjun
hai.
Haan, you're right. It's Arjun. So, the nursery is spread all over. And now you can see that these all will be moved.
Slowly to the bigger bag.
This is all dog. So we have done very well
with
dog.
Oh, this is all dog.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
We have really done well with dog. So there is... we also have something done with stem. We get stem cutting.
Mm-hmm.
And with stem cutting, we grow... We have this. Can you see the sprouting?
Yeah.
So you also do... get saplings out of stem.
Stem, yeah. Okay. Wonderful.
Barring
so without the seed.
Without the seed.
That's salai.
That's salai.
That's the, it has an incense.
Yes, absolutely. Again, it becomes a large tree. We have quite a grown salai out here. Yeah, almost all of them have one species somewhere or the other. We have tried to plant them around. So, you know, at any point in time you want to close this nursery or you want to move it somewhere, the place will be fully planted. Yes.
Great, Latika. Thank you for that wonderful walk the talk kind of introduction to the biodiversity park and your journey. You've all shared that how beautiful a journey this has been for you.
Yes, it has been.
Any last words, any message to the listeners of this video? And, you know, I'm hoping that more people see this, get inspired around the country. There are more urban forests or non-urban small forests that come up, you know.
I think what we have been able to achieve is really a public-private partnership. And I personally feel if we really want more and more forests to come like this, this is the only way to do it. You cannot have them running only just by forest or privately. So it has to be a partnership. And it's a possibility because this is there.
Wonderful. With that positive note, thank you very much.
Thank you.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you.